Imagine the country you live in being hit by less and less fertile soil, making crop growing increasingly difficult.
Sandstorm conditions prevail in the Indian capital, and now there are fears of early desertification of the region.
Desertification and erosion are both concerns.
Soil is the habitat upon which zillions of lives thrive. Because of that thriving life, everything grows. We eat food, other animals grow, everything happens because soil is rich. Once there is no richness in soil, then you have forsaken the planet in many ways.
We talk of carbon, we talk of emissions, we talk of pollution at various levels. Before all that, we need to address the most important concern, because there is a misunderstanding in the world. There is a campaign to project civic issues as environmental issues. Right now, if plastic bags are floating around in New York City, this is not an ecological issue, this is a civic issue. If our rivers are polluted, this can be fixed. In 1 or 2 years, if you set up the necessary purification plants and enforce the law, these are civic issues which can be fixed with a little bit of law enforcement and awareness. But the real issue is soil.
The United Nations agencies, with enough scientific data, they're clearly saying that we have soil, agricultural soil, for another 80 to 100 crops on the planet. This is 45 to 60 years is what we have agricultural soil. We are calling this a soil extinction. You've heard of dinosaurs going extinct, you have heard of dodos going extinct, but this is soil extinction is what we are looking at. The real problem is soil extinction, because in the last 30 years, 80% of the biomass insects have disappeared from the planet, 80%. This is a suicide, you know, this is a real suicide.
So in 45 years' time or 50 years' time, there will be serious food crisis on the planet, it's inevitable. When food crisis comes, well, whoever has the biggest guns will come and take the food. And the chaos and the suffering that we will create for populations around the world is unimaginable. Don't think only the poor people will die, they will kill the rich and rich will die. So this is not to paint a dark picture, this is a reality which has happened many times in our history, and once again it is being predicted by top scientists in the world. So what are we going to do?
Why is soil going away? Where is it going away? See, what is sand becomes soil if you add organic content to it. What is soil becomes sand if you take away all the organic content from it. If you go into a rainforest, the organic content in the soil will be over 70%. In normal agricultural soil, the minimum organic content that has to be there to call soil soil is 3 to 6%. 3% is the most minimum. But today, for example, in India, 62% of India's soil, the organic content is 0.5% or below that. So literally we are on the verge of desertification. This is across the world, this is not in one country. In United States, the way the land has been used in terms of herbicides, weedicides, pesticides, well, we need to understand nearly 82 to 86% of biodiversity is within the first 12 inches of topsoil. When we plow with machines like tractors plow to a depth of 9 to 12 inches and leave it open, this means we are destroying the biodiversity completely. What biodiversity means is, it's the humus in the soil. The word human comes from the word humus. That means this is actually living soil.
So it's very, very important that soil becomes the focus, because if you put 1/3 to 40% of the land, especially in the tropical world, under tree shade, your climate change could be easily reversed. Land is getting hot simply because it is plowed or it is paved. Land has to go under vegetation, whatever kind, natural grasses, bushes, trees, whatever, because all these are serving the ecological activity. And we must also understand soil is a very significant carbon sink. And soil is the largest water soak on the planet. And soil is the basis of all life. This 36 to 39 inches of topsoil on average around the planet is the basis of 87% of life on this planet. To keep the biodiversity alive is the most important thing that we need to do right now. Unless we start now, this will not happen. As a part of this, we are unfolding a movement called Conscious Planet to bring maximum number of people. Right now, it looks like climate change, ecology, all these are playground for the rich and elite. No, this must change. Individual human beings should become conscious about the danger that we are facing. Ecological issues must become election issues, and political parties must give significance to ecological issues in their manifestos. Governments must be elected for their concern for ecological issues. This needs to happen.
So, we are seeing how to bring about a policy recommendation for 192 countries. The rally is starting on 21st of March, which is the equinox day in London. And from London, it's a single lone motorcycle riding through 24 countries, 30,000 kilometers, reaching the Kaveri Basin, where we are on ground working in a river basin, which is 83,000 square kilometers, and 5.2 million farmers work here.
The very body that we carry is soil. Without soil being rich and well, this body and every other life cannot be well. So in terms of ecology, in terms of climate change, the most important thing is that we need to have a conscious approach as to how we manage our soil, how we rejuvenate our soil, how we revitalize our soil. This conscious approach and creating a conscious planet is what is most important. Without involving large mass of people, this will not become a reality, because we are democratic nations. Unless people say this is what they want, that is not going to happen. So let's create a conscious planet. Let us make it happen.